My mom was diagnosed with dementia over 20 years ago. Her age was she was just turning 70 years old. At that time, I was not the primary caregiver, but I was the only daughter in the family. My father and mother were living in their own home. As time has gone, my mom's dementia has progressively moved to different stages, but because of the different support systems we have had, the fact that there were primary caregivers like myself, we had 24-hour nursing. We also for a long time have had the support of the Alzheimer's Foundation. Today she is 91 years old, and we manage the condition. It's never easy, but it is always managing and coping and understanding and evolving with the patient. As the primary caregiver is me, she lives with me now as my father has passed away and she's moved in with me. And I am the primary caregiver at present. As I said, my mom has had Alzheimer's for 20 years. It has been a journey. What I'm going to be able to tell you all now is not the level of understanding I had at the beginning. So now that I have the experience, there are very clear do's and don'ts in being the primary caregiver. One is try and get educated or spend time with the Alzheimer's Foundation or somebody who has had been a primary caregiver to understand how to take care. One of the first things you must remember is that you cannot sometimes differentiate whether they understand or don't understand. So do not ever say no or it is not so. She might or he might tell you, no, this is not my house. Trying to reinforce her and say, no, this is your house, will never bring peace to you or the patient. So always agree with the patient. It may be the most unreasonable thing that they would come up with, but always agree and pacify, because 5 minutes later, they have forgotten it. At the beginning stages, my mom was very active. You must remember, when you get Alzheimer's, the age is not defined, your activity is not defined. Very often you're physically very active. You are able to do whatever. The patient can have the ability to continue working or continue going to the kitchen and cooking or continuing to take care of somebody, because she or he does not understand that they have dementia or Alzheimer's, because that is not something that they do understand. So you have to learn not to say no and to be very observant, and never underestimate that there can be an accident. There can be a situation where they can walk out of a door. They can, you know, accidentally keep a kitchen fire on because they'll forget to put it off. So it's important that as they get it and as they evolve, you would be more conscious. But in the beginning stages, you have to be aware, you have to be conscious, you have to constantly have people around them, monitoring them and taking care of them. One of the biggest problems we hear is when they get it at a very young age and they have been active, they can write checks, they have access to their bank accounts. 1 minute they'll remember to go and put their teller card and take money out, and you may not even know. So it's very important that people understand that they never get back to normal. Routine is very important. We must keep them in a routine. Stability comes for their condition by routine. You have to have a routine. What time they eat, what time they have a bath, what time they go out, where they go, how they go, if they have a drive, if they go for a visit. It must be routinely planned, because anything out of that routine disturbs them. People that they wouldn't see normally, if accidentally drop by, it disturbs them. Because sometimes they can relate and sometimes they will recognize and have a normal conversation. Sometimes they'll get disturbed. So it's very important that they have routine. And if anything out of the routine is happening, you have to pre-prepare and get ready that there can be a perfect transition in that routine change, or it can be completely berserk. It would go completely in the wrong direction. So my mom has Alzheimer's for 20 years, but one of the things that it has not got progressively very aggressive, because we have consciously kept her occupied. We have routine, we have mental stimulating games that we do. We play cards, we play jigsaw puzzles. She was always an artist, so we make her draw. We used to, before it was very progressive, she used to go to a senior citizen's day out with her carer, of course, and she would participate in playing cards, she would participate in playing games. She would always be kept active, but in a routine manner. She would know every day at 5 o'clock she would go for a drive, because she loved going for a drive. At 5 o'clock she would go for a drive, and then she would come back with a little snack that she would eat. It could be anything. It could be just being at home and somebody visiting her at a particular time. Routine is really important, and mind stimulating games, making her play cards, you know, just snap, or making pairs, or giving her a coloring book and making sure that she colors within the lines. It's almost like, you know, Montessori activities, but it actually stimulates their mind. It keeps them occupied, it gives them a purpose of, for that period of time that they're up. Being a primary caregiver, it is not easy. You love your parents or whoever the person that you're taking care of. Like me, I'm taking care of my mother. I love her, and I want to do everything possible to make her comfortable, to make her happy. But it is not a two-way communication. So you wouldn't get her showing any appreciation back. And that's really hard when you're a caregiver, because at one minute they would be so receptive, and the next minute they are not. So you need to have a support system. You need to have a break from it. You need to understand that it's okay if you break down and you cry and you sometimes feel you can't take it anymore. It's normal, but to have a support group, I am blessed. I have a brother and a sister-in-law and brothers that, you know, come every Sunday and spend time with my mom and us. I have had breaks that my sister-in-law has been the primary caregiver for a period of time. It is not easy. When my mom and dad used to live together, my father couldn't understand my mother, you know, because his love for her was like, she wants to get mom back to being normal. So being a primary caregiver is also pacifying the partner of your mother, that's my father. So it is not an easy task. I'm blessed to have even the Alzheimer's Center, because it's a break. It's a break even to my nurse or the caregiver, because she gets a break from my mom, from, you know, going out and having other people to take care and seeing other patients. You kind of then kind of rejuvenate and reset yourself to look after your mom or your whoever you're looking after as the primary caregiver. But it is not easy. My sincere thanks and appreciation goes to the Alzheimer's Association. My mom has had the privilege of being one of their first patients. They have, long before the Alzheimer's Foundation had a building and a place, they have a volunteers like Yasmin and the founder members, Lorraine, who used to come and do home visits, you know, and talk to my dad and help my dad to understand. So they have been an immense support. And of course, 10 years ago, when they opened the Alzheimer's Center, my mom has been one of the first regular visitors. And I think part of her success, she's 91 now, she's been going there since she was 80. She is also, her success of her well-being has been this outing that she has had regularly. And the Alzheimer's walks, the way I was able to help other people who are going through it, because I can send them to the Alzheimer's Center, they can have assessments, people can start understanding about Alzheimer's, the awareness weeks that we do, the fabulous Alzheimer's walks that I have participated continuously for many years. You see, you know, normal people asking us questions, you know, what is this? Oh, we want to know about it. But mainly they have been an immense support system to me and my family in taking care of my mom.